Okay, so not as big of a gap between the last vlog update and this one, which is a good thing, really. So what I wanted to do in this one is just update you on a couple of things about what's going on and the state of the magazine book thing that I was in the middle of completing. So in the last vlog, you'll have seen that I got the proof copy for my new zine, Book of Shadows. And it wasn't really up to scratch. So I went back to Blurb and I had a bit of a chat with their customer service, and they recommended that I do it on the premium magazine. And I thought, okay, yeah, fair enough. That just means I've got to quickly, fiddle a couple of things and upload it. And it really wasn't an issue. It was pretty easy to do. So that's finally come now. And the results are so much better that what I thought I would do is I would do like a little side-by-side comparison. So that's what we're going to do now. Okay, so here's the original. As you can see, there's lots of print marks on it. There's this white bit at the bottom, and they explained to me this is basically printed on an inkjet printer. So for dark colours like all this, it's just not very good, and it's you can see there's bits already starting to come away, and it's just yeah, the quality of it is not great. You can see all the scratches and things there, so it's not the best quality. It's okay if you were going to do something that was a bit lighter, a bit easier, I don't know, maybe like a comic book or something along those lines, that would probably be fine. But for the quality I'm after, I wanted something a bit more heavy duty. So fast forward over to this, and you can see this has come in a nice plastic envelope. Hold on, let me just try and get this out. So already that's top marks for me. Nice plastic envelope. You can see the colour saturation is a bit nicer on this one. I think there's a bit more detail on it. The binding feels a lot stronger. See, this one just feels like, you can see where it's already starting to come away. This one feels a lot more like a magazine, like a proper quality product. The cover feels thicker, as you can see, and there's no print marks through it. There's no scratches or print marks or anything. Everything has come through really, really nice. And the quality and the detail is where I wanted it to be. There's none of that white nonsense at the bottom. You can see blacks are nice and saturated, the whites are nice and bright. No scratching or anything on the back. So yes, much, much happier with that now. So you can find this on Blurb if you search Imagine Mortis, Book of Shadows, or you can go to my website, www.imaginemortis.co.uk, and you will be able to just click on book page and it's all there with the technical information. So what I've done is I've tried to keep this, the whole idea behind this is I was trying to keep this as cheap as possible, because I see a lot of pre-printed, self-published books that are, 30 pages and they're like 30 odd pounds, because obviously people have got to put a markup on them. But what I thought would be a better idea would be to have this in a kind of a nice magazine format, decent magazine format, and that would keep the price around about £10. And the listing price is £10.39 on that, so that's quite good. Doesn't give me a huge profit margin, but that's not really what this is about, because I use a lot of print-on-demand services for my publishing, my merchandise and all that kind of things. And I do make a very, very small profit margin on it. But really, it's just a way to get my artwork out there. And that's all I'm really bothered about at the moment. So you can go onto my website, you can find the Book of Shadows page really easily, click the link on there, go buy it. The price obviously doesn't include shipping or local import taxes, because they do tend to vary. But I think for around about a tenner, that's pretty good going. So I'm very, very happy with this. So another couple of things I wanted to show you is just some recent artwork that I've done while I've been in lockdown. I tend not to do too much in just basic acrylics. If you've ever looked at my artwork, you'll see that most of it is watercolour with some maybe acrylic embellishments. But I decided to just do a couple on canvas so I could basically hang them on the wall, and there'd be a little memento of 2020, my thought processes of 2020. So this is the first one I want to show you. This is called Saint Invictus, and basically it's my take on the medieval depiction of the wound man, which I think is a fairly apt metaphor for how a lot of people are feeling. You know, we're constantly being, you know, bombarded with things, and there's a lot of painful things going on, but and, you know, despite our outward vulnerability, we're still kind of serenely plodding along. So I thought I'd take that. And the reason I sort of made it more like a saint rather than a traditional depicted wound man was I've always sort of thought that the depictions of Saint Sebastian, who you remember, survived being shot by a hail of arrows in like the 3rd century or something like that. Before being bludgeoned. He is also the patron, amongst other things, of people stricken with plague. So I thought that was quite an apt metaphor for this painting. So this is hanging in my house at the moment. And yeah, so that's basically what I just wanted to take you through on that one. So the kind of the religious and the spiritual and the you know, as well as the anatomical and the medical kind of sides to it, that I think, you know, were in the thought processes behind that one. So there's that one. Okay, so the logic behind this one is I kind of wanted to put a face to the year. So it was a bit blurry, this. Maybe because the shadows are a bit bad. But anyway, yes, so as you can see, there's the symbol of Saturn on his head and the crown. So that gives you a clue that this is my sort of depiction of Saturn, which, if you remember from your mythology, ate his children. And of course, Saturn in Greek mythology is Kronos, and the Greek kind of tragedy mask is what I was going for here. So he's got a very sinister grin on one side, a very sort of mocking or Didums kind of frown on the other, and in the middle it's just a very, very angry I'm going to eat you kind of face. So for me, that just kind of sums up how 2020 has been so far, a kind of mocking tragical comedy of a year that just seems to be set on devouring us all. So I think that alongside the St. Invictus painting kind of sums it all up for me this year. Of course, I've got another painting as well, Annus Horribilis, which I did in watercolour. It was a bit more Dali inspired. It was just kind of more a vision of an apocalypse, like a dreamlike apocalypse. So I'll drop that picture down on top of this as well, so you can see that. And that's kind of like the third piece in my kind of 2020 cycle. And yeah, the idea behind that one was just to kind of have this great big red skull appearing in the sky, and, you know, some people quite serenely walking towards it, other people cowering and praying as a city sort of smokes just slightly off to the side. So that was kind of my thinking behind that. And yeah, there's one more thing I want to show you in this vlog. So hopefully you can see this. It's a bit bright out here, and this is on the back fence where it gets all the sun, but I made a wind chime out of some ethically sourced sheep bones that you can see here. So they do clank about a little bit. I ended up using fishing twine and hot glue, so it's not the neatest of things, but it's got all these runes and bind runes carved into it. So Debs wanted one of these, so I decided to make her one. Burnt myself a few times with the hot glue, but I think it came out quite nice, just for a nice garden ornament. So yeah, there's that as well. So of course these are all ethically sourced from sheep walking, and what I've done is, because they were kind of an more of a brown colour, I painted them with acrylic spray paint and then went over that with some black to give it a kind of more worn look, and then carved the runes into the paint rather than the bone, which is very, very difficult to do because these bones are surprisingly hard. But yeah, so that's that. I don't know if you can quite see it all. There we go. Lose a lot of the detail there, but there's that. So I'm quite happy with that. I'll probably do it a lot differently if I made another one to sell or something, but yeah, it's still come out all right, I think. So that's just a quick update of some of the bits and pieces that I've been creating recently. Obviously you'll be able to see more on my Instagram, and the link for that is below this video as always. And yeah, so I hope everyone out there is doing well. I hope you're all coping with the lockdowns and the quarantines and just the utter madness of it all at the moment. So yeah, it's a difficult time for everyone. Some people are having it more difficult than others. I wholeheartedly acknowledge that. I'm coping quite well with everything. I'm working from home. Debs is obviously a frontline worker, so she's having to go to work at the hospital every day, but she's managing, she's coping, you know, obviously with it being Lincolnshire and being quite a rural area, social distancing is easy to do if you're not being silly about things. So, you know, with all that in mind, we're quite lucky at the moment. We've got a roof over our heads. We're able to, you know, still do what we need to do, go out and buy food, you know, do the garden. You know, Debs has been on an absolute blitz recently, painting fences and buying, you know, bits and pieces for it and just making it look, you know, it's a good time, you know, at the moment to get these things sorted that you've been meaning to do for the past couple of years. But anyway, so I hope you're all doing okay out there. Hope you're all coping. You know, it's a tough time. We're all in this together, and obviously, you know, if you can get your fresh air, get your exercise. Look at me telling you to do that. It's utter bullshit. I'm barely getting any exercise. I'm barely getting any fresh air. I don't cope with the heat. So my idea of fresh air is sitting in the back garden and watching the bats in the evening, or going outside and playing with one of the neighbour's cats, you know. And it's enough. Anyway, so I'm going to wrap this up here because I'm starting to ramble now. So as always, you know, please like, subscribe, check out the links below, have a look at the book page on my website, check out Instagram for the latest updates, and hopefully I will see you again soon.